They are skillful.
Hello, art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. For this video, I wanted to take a look at an interior shot of a horse barn in Ocean City, Maryland. I started out using my clear ruler, and I taped off a piece of paper off to the left side so that I could get the one-point perspective. This is kind of a long corridor, so it's fairly obvious that this is going to be sort of a long one-point perspective shot. So I taped off a piece of paper, and I got the eye line right about where the horse's eyes are, because that's about where I was standing or holding out my phone. And you can see everything beneath the horse's eyes are all tilted, fanning downwards. And above the eye level, you can see they're all kind of fanning the other way, going upward. So I created a kind of arbitrary grid, and then I used my ruler to make some straight, a bunch of arbitrary vertical lines that I could kind of snap to. I was trying to make sure I got some of the major shapes and shape changes, and then detail a little bit in the drawing, but a lot of that stuff in the background I'm going to allow to just dissolve and melt. I just wanted to make sure I had a structure there. Especially when it came to the horse's heads, because they're pretty difficult to draw. They can be kind of off-looking if you're not careful, and so I wanted to make sure I had a good structure for this, and then start to knock out the value. I started by asking myself, what's the lightest thing in this? And to me, it was the areas where the sunlight was directly coming into the room and shining on the ground. So with that said, I decided to knock everything else down, just as the first step. Get rid of all the white except for the places I want to be the absolute most brightest in the scene, using some yellow ochre and some lavender and a little bit of cobalt blue. From here on, until I get to the horse's heads, I'm going to close one eye, I'm going to squint at my reference, and try to judge the values, and just start to knock in these shapes that I'm seeing, focusing more on the abstract shapes I'm seeing, and not too much about the detail of the structure of what I'm looking at. Except for places where it would help to stroke with the form, for example, the ground, pulling along with the form, and the walls pouring up, pulling up with the wall, and then the ceiling at that certain angle it's at, pulling with that form, so that will hopefully kind of help to give a more atmospheric feel to the scene. I'm always varying from warm to cool to warm to cool, you can see all over. I don't allow any spot to be too much of one particular temperature or color. There's nothing wrong with that stylistically if you were to choose to do things in a certain color or focus on local color. For me, this scene is more about the horses, but also the general atmosphere of standing in this barn and looking at these animals, and kind of the feeling you get when you're standing there and sort of looking at the whole room. So I wanted to go for the whole atmosphere of the room, and to do that, I wanted to focus my details on the things that are interesting to me, in this case the horses, but allow everything else to kind of fall away, become less important. So I'm doing a lot of wet into wet shapes, and I'm closing an eye and squinting constantly, focusing on just the value that I see, and not the awareness of what the object is that I'm sketching. I can switch back and forth between a variety of different types of brushes to get a different kind of pull and line. I want to make sure that I have a contrast of those elements. It's just one tool that I have in my tool chest to bring contrast to an image. So the strokes, for example, the blocks of shapes, I can make sure that they're varied between the very fat and the very thin. Thick, thin, big, small. These contrasts are going to go a long way in terms of giving interest to the image and helping to hopefully draw the viewer into the scene. Once I'm happy with the major shapes of value, I can start to use the side of the brush to rake in some of that texture. Once I'm happy with the overall room, I can start to work on the individual horses' heads. To do that, I'm going to use a general kind of local color that's pitched towards the light. So using, in this case, yellow ochre, some burnt sienna, to get a nice warm overall silhouette started. Then I can come back with some burnt umber and ultramarine, much more thickly, so much less water. And I'm just going to look at the horse, and I see all these light bits where it's turning outward or upward. It's catching a little bit of light on the fur. I want to keep it looking like fur, though. Make sure that there's a distinction between how the horse's fur is treated and the walls and the ground all around it to make sure that it feels organic and it feels alive. So I'm doing this wet into wet directly because I want to make sure that all those little transitions between the lighter patches that I put down in the original silhouette and these darker patches of value that I'm setting down will be soft in their transitions. I can also use that dark box behind the horse to help use that negative drawing to draw in the lighter part on the horse and make it a little more obvious. I'm going to take a similar approach with this horse, although I'm going to use more lavender and a little bit of cobalt blue in the higher parts of the horse because this is a darker fur on this horse. So it's catching some of this sort of ambient blue cool light that where the light's kind of bouncing around, maybe getting picked up by a nearby window. You're getting some of those sort of cool notes on the horse. You could come back later with gouache or something and try to come back and put that on top, but what I'm going to try to do is treat it like I did the other one, which is to build a large silhouette of what I'm doing and then bring some very thick paint with next to no water in it and start to set in the darker bits that I'm seeing and allow them to kind of melt together and create this soft, subtle transition area to area, hopefully feeling like a turn of form of fur. This stage in the sketch, I feel like most of the heavy lifting is done, and I feel like the lessons have been learned, so I'm just sort of noodling away at the detail. I can do this as long as I want to. I just want to make sure that what I'm doing adds to the statement and isn't overkill in terms of detail. I don't want to go too far. And that's going to be it for this demo. There's a full-length version on Patreon if you're interested in painting along with a reference. But in the meantime, that's it for this one, and I will see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.